It is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Kansas City Chiefs. They go play fake. Mahomes. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
And there shouldn't be any surprise at all when we watch him flash his arm. Easy motion, easy action, and that ball flies downfield.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now an option play on second down. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and 9. Throw left side complete. That's Bell. He'll wind up being stopped for no gain, and it'll lead to a fourth down.
They dialed up the blitz on third down, and your worry as a defense that they can hit you with a big play in that situation. Instead, the blitz pays off, able to rally to the football and make the play.
On fourth down, Tommy Townsend to punt for Kansas City. The All-Pro Deontay Harris deep for New Orleans. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. Able to shake free for about 7 up to the 35. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. On the ground, Kamara. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
The third-year defensive tackle out of Florida State, Derek Nnadi, with a nice play there. Started every game for Kansas City during their Super Bowl run a season ago.
Hill to throw on 3rd and 1. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. He's got first down and then some at midfield. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 14 yards through the air, caught the D off guard on 3rd and 1. First down and 2. Left side here to Sanders. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play. Out of the gun, Hill. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Traquan Smith, the intended receiver, but it'll be 2nd down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline. But do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. Now this throw caught left side. Touchdown, New Orleans! Michael Thomas, 58 yards. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the 3 and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on 3 and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this. We're going to stuff it. Then we're going to take the ball. They won't be able to keep up with us. And they got it done.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On second and nine, Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. That catch good for five. It's third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Now Mahomes. And 3 yards there, takes him to the 45.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That one complete to Hill. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Looking for Watkins and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Here's Hill now after the interception. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 10 yards there and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. They'll run. This is Kamara. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held him to no gain.
Throwing on second down. Hill. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. From the gun, here's Hill. And he can't find a receiver and he's brought down. The big money man, Chris Jones, getting in there to bring him to the ground.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they, a dime? What were they?
15 cents.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Mahomes now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And that gonna be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Mahomes to throw once more. Steps away to his left. And he'll get this to the 40, but that's still going to be a few yards short of the first down. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset, he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. Calls for the fair catch, makes the fair catch just inside the 15-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Saints will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. They'll try and run it. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Chris Jones on the stop.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. A shotgun snap for Hill. Rolling to his right. Now he'll pull it down. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
Hill on first down. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. Now they couldn't get anything going there out on the right side in the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
To throw again on second down. Hill. It's intercepted. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And this is going to be incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From midfield, here's Mahomes. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards there, first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
Well, we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam! Puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion. Really good pickup.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. DeMario Davis makes the tackle. He led the Saints in that category in 2019. Four receivers now in the formation. Three to the left, one to the right on second and 7. Mahomes gonna throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And the Chiefs are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line. Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down. And this carry brought to an end at the 8. Good stick skills, just not much room there to operate. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing, and as a player, that means an awful lot.
On second down, it's Bell, and he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal. Looking to throw is Mahomes. He'll get this underneath to Bell. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs' field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Butker's kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And we will not see a run back here from Harris. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 16 yards, a first down.
Now, how about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great arm strength on that one, able to drive the football. Quarterbacks love it when they can show off their arms.
Now it's Kamara in the passing game, and they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And brought in by the tight end, Cook. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. A good down to possibly take a shot, and in fact, they'll come up with an empty backfield on second and inches. Throwing again is Hill. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. To the air again. Hill. He'll buy some time right. And now he's going to use his legs. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The gun, Hill, and that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. Jared Cook, his Pro Bowl tight end, was the target, but it'll be second and goal. Operating from the gun, Hill. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a gain of a couple on what should be the final carry of half number one. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
On the return, Deontay Harris. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. On second down, Kamara. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now it appears we've got a Chief moving pretty gingerly down there. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. From the gun, Hill. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler Michael Thomas was the intended receiver. And now it's second down. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Throwing again. Hill. Oh, now it's free. Hill fumbled it. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Second and 3, and they trail 7-3, but getting close to changing that, and this defense hoping to limit them to a field goal to preserve the lead. Now Mahomes on the bootleg. Complete, the tight end Kelsey. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. The start for them near flawless. Defense gets them a 3-and-out, 2 quick pass connections on offense.
So that's how a team works together, just what you described. Get them the ball, give them a little momentum, and they're capitalizing off of that. Thanks a lot, guys.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Malcolm Brown at 3 bills and some change comes in to drop the hammer. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire. They get just a yard back there, and now they'll be looking at a tough 3rd and 15.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And Robinson with a big catch. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run with Edwards-Helaire, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Second and goal from the 6 this time. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. DeMarcus Robinson there to make the grab, and the Chiefs have taken the lead. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Extra point right down the middle, and the lead is now 10-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Here's Harris to return it. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this game.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. On the ground, this is Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. And down to the 27-yard line. 24 yards to gain there. Another first down as well.
Alvin Kamara hit the NFL with a bang, had double-digit touchdowns in his first two seasons. Now, production fell off a little bit last year. Just six times did he find the end zone. But his ability to run it and catch it out of the backfield makes him hard to cover. Look for a bounce-back season in 2020.
Here's a ball thrown right side and complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him. Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Again, it's Kamara. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. Call it a gain of three, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Back now here live in New Orleans. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And I don't think Kamara got there. Looks like they stopped him short. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Lutz puts this one through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
Now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Give him 18 yards on that one. On first down, Mahomes. Caught out left side by Robinson. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary, and I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. After the penalty, it's Bell. And he'll get about three, just outside the 10, stopped at the 11. Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. They'll go again with Bell. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Chiefs have broken our tie as they take the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that, and it wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes it a 17-10 score. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. On first down, it's Hill. And incomplete. Crisis averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again. Hill. Oh, he want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
The Saints on third down, just one for three thus far. This is third and 10. Back to throw, Hill. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he'll kick it away for the second time. That'll be a 41-yard punt, just 1 yard on the return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Malcolm Brown picks up his second sack of the afternoon. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. The 30. 10. And for a Kansas City touchdown.
Let's go!
Tyreek Hill, 76 yards. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
And the lead is up to 14. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. From the gun, here's Hill. That'll be complete to Cook. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
Looking to throw again on second down. Hill. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver, and it's third down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork that led to the incompletion. It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time on fourth for him. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on second down, or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. Second and 12, and you have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This to make it a three-score game late. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he
up.
Trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much. And I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
We'll see what his offense can do. On second and 10, Hill. Smith catches left side. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. It's a first down on a gain of 10. The Saints in the hurry up here. Clock continuing to roll. On first down, Hill gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? He'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Hill now operating from the red zone. And Cook has it left side. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. Hill throwing once more. This will be caught at about the 6. And the Saints are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. So this one in the win column for Kansas City, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from the Bayou.